Hello, this is Amanda from T's Original Arts.
And I've got some colors here that my niece wanted for a project. I'm going to try them out for her. I've got some wild iris, some royal gold, some bright orange, true blue, turquoise, white. And I put some coconut milk in everything except for the orange and gold. And I've got my little cups all mixed up here. I used my magic sauce, which is Floetrol glue and GAC 800, a 3-2-1 mix. And then I mixed all my paints, two parts medium, one part paint. And so on an 8x10 canvas, I should need 3 ounces of paint. I've got 2 3-ounce cups here. I'm going to start layering this in. I'm going to put a little bit of white in the bottom first, and then I'm going to go ahead and layer it. I'm not going to layer it any more than 2 times because I don't want to get mud. So I just put a little bit of white in the bottom, not very much. And then I'm going to start her off with light blue. And I'm not going to be using all of this paint, because like I said, I only need 3 ounces. These are each 2-ounce cups. So I'm gonna go blue, light blue, and I'm gonna do orange. And then I'm gonna do dark blue. Oops, got some dark blue in my orange there. That's no good. Let me do gold. I'm going to do purple. That's probably at least 3 ounces of paint there. Let me see if I can get this blue out of here. There we go. A little bit of orange in each cup again. I want that blue to contaminate my orange. Some blue. White. I forgot to do my white last time. Why didn't you remind me? And then we're gonna go, I think we'll do gold. And then we'll do the light blue. And then we'll do the purple. I'm going to have some paint left over here, which is fine, because if this all turns out the way she wants it, then we're going to do some triptychs. Aha. All right. So I'm going to do, I'm going to have way too much paint for this canvas. I only needed 3 ounces. I'm going to have close to 6. It's going to be a lot of runoff. Gosh, I hate to waste that much paint. I think I'm going to do 2 of these, because that's pretty close to 3 ounces. Let me finish topping this off. Change my mind. We can do that because we're artists. I'll put a little bit more white on top. Whoops. Oh. That's why I always close the top on my secret sauce. There we go. A little bit more white. And then we'll do a little bit more purple. Orange. I'm breaking my rule of not layering things more than twice by doing this, but I really didn't want to waste that much paint, especially if I only need 3 ounces to do a 8x10 canvas, right? Okay, so there's my 3-ounce cup. It's full. I'm going to go ahead and put it on my canvas, put it right like this, flip it upside down. There we go. And while that's sitting there, I'm going to go ahead and put some more, the rest of my paint on this one. I might as well, huh? I'll do this in a little different order. The rest of the gold on there. Because we're just waiting at this point. And then put the rest of the purple on there. There we go. And I think I'm going to top it off with orange. And leave the 2 blues. That another 3-ounce cup. Boom. Perfect. So I can do a second one of these, and I'll do that one off camera. These videos tend to get a little carried away with length. We don't want to do that. We want to get in, get you the information you want to know, and get out as quick as possible. Okay. So I'm going to take and I'm going to squirt a little white paint around here. That's going to help it flow. I'm going to pick it up. Let some ooze out. Ooh, look at that. Now I'm going to go like this. I'm just making a line down the side here. Okay, we're going to let that sit there for just a second. I'm going to go grab a big popsicle stick. And my torch. I got this big old honking torch, see? I'm going to pop a couple bubbles. There we go. We don't want to get too carried away. Cells start popping up there like that. Mm-hmm. I like it too. Put some paint in the corner. Corners are kind of hard to do. So I like to put a little extra in the corners. There we go. Take care of the corners for now. All right, now we're going to start moving this baby around. And I think I'm going to go down this way first. Oh, yeah. Good. I'm going to stop. I'm going to bring it back up to the middle. Mm-hmm. Look how liquidy that is. Oh, it's so nice. I just love this medium. Okay, we'll go all the way back up to this corner. We're stretching those cells in the middle out. Good. Now we're going to go back to the middle. All right.
go down to that corner. I'm going to stop. I'm going to come back up to this corner. And this is where I'm going to use my popsicle stick. Because there's some stuff here that I don't want to totally lose. There we go. And that way it goes back on the... Doesn't all run off, see? Then it goes down the side. There. And I could put this right here. You like that? Kind of like cheating. All right. Now we're going to go back over here. I kind of like that orange up there at the top. Gosh, that's nice. A lot of this is all about, you know, how you tip it and where you pour it. What you do with it. There we go. That's enough on that side. Boy, those cells are looking nice. I really like what's happening. Isn't that pretty? They're getting so nice and big. And my niece, she is all about the big cells. She says, I like big cells and I cannot lie. I'm just kidding. I do silly things while I'm painting. Whoops. Come on, get over there. The corners are really tricky sometimes, so that's another good reason to use a popsicle stick. I'm really digging this this orange. I'll pull it back down this way a little bit. Let's see if I can throw this up here, and that way I can get the runoff. There we go. Help it flow. Good. I like it. So far, so good. I'll get this, fix this corner here. I'll get him fixed before I do anything else. I love that orange. I'm going to get it down here on the end here. Move it back this way a little bit. There we go. Pull those cells over from the side. Catch them on the popsicle stick. There we go. Let them flow down. Nice. Nice. Get up here, catch these guys. Don't want to lose my orange though. Come on. Almost lost my canvas. Okay. It's a pretty nice looking. I just got to get over here and get this one. Some more down there in that corner. All right, so I might have to cheat here because I really don't want to stretch that top up anymore. Sometimes I'll take my squirt bottle and I'll squirt some white up underneath there like that. And then I can tip it this way. And over this way, kind of off camera, and over this way, there we go, and pull it back down, and then back over this way. All right, Now this is where I would normally take a quick look at it, decide whether or not I should torch it. If I had used a little bit more paint, I wouldn't have had to stretch it as much to get it to cover the canvas. And then my cells probably would have stayed a little bit bigger. But now watch what happens when I torch it. I'm going to give it a quick torch.